Most of my work focuses on the valuation of damages from air pollution and greenhouse gas emissions in the U.S. economy. And we use that to do two things. We design policies to correct those market failures, and we also deduct those damages from measures like GDP to try to move towards a more comprehensive measure of economic output. Traditional measures focus on market income and wages and capital income, and what my work can do is value the exposures that people have across the country to things like air pollution, and then deduct those costs that are incurred from exposure from their income and compute the distribution in that measure. And what my work finds is that the growth rate in that measure, the adjusted measure, has actually outpaced the growth of GDP in the U.S. economy. Why is that important? It's important because the conventional dialogue is one in which investments in environmental quality necessarily deduct from economic performance. And the argument implicit in my work is that it only deducts from economic performance if your measure of performance doesn't include the benefits from environmental policy. So I argue that the economy has actually been growing more rapidly than we thought because we've been cleaning up for the past 10 to 15 years. Recently, I've become more interested in historic trends, and in particular, thinking about the trends in air pollution emissions and their impact throughout the 20th century in the U.S. economy. Now, what's challenging about that is we really only began tracking emissions and air quality levels rigorously in the U.S. since 1970. And so what we have to do are develop some techniques to try to estimate conditions moving back to, say, World War II. So a primary challenge and a pursuit I have in terms of fundraising is to develop a research program that will allow us to explore what were the conditions in terms of environmental quality, in terms of pollution intensity in the U.S. economy during the post-war boom. The perspective that my work offers is that economists are thinking about things that happen outside the market boundary that involve health effects or ecosystem services. And in fact, the principles that we use are perfectly suitable to the calculation of the value of those things and to the incorporation into a more broad measure of economic performance and policy evaluation.